Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. We got
blood. All right, so shout out to the Swifties. You guys have been hitting me up, wanting me to talk about this whole We Stand With Taylor Swift drama that's going on social media. So if you're not up to date, honey, make sure you guys have your teacups ready because I'm getting ready to spill all this Taylor Swift tea, okay? We haven't talked about Taylor in a few years. That's my girl. Everybody knows I'm a low-key Swiftie. I love her music. I have all her albums, and, you know, I don't care. Feel free to judge me, okay? Feel free. Any damn way. So this is what's going on with Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift is really upset because, as you guys all know, when she was 15 years old, she signed a horrible contract that most up-and-coming artists end up signing. And basically, she was signed to a 6-album deal by Scott Brochetta, who is the head of Big Machine Records. So she signed this when she was 15 years old, and basically, they held her under contract. I believe she ended up going to Warner Music Group because they refused to let her buy her rights, her publishing. They said they would only let her buy it if she was willing to stay with them like another year and, you know, drop another album. It was a bunch of mess. So she walked away, and this weekend she found out that Scooter Braun, who is the manager of Kim Kardashian, Justin Bieber, Ariana Grande, he's a huge time manager in Hollywood. He basically bought all of her publishing for $300 million. And when I tell you, Taylor Swift went on this huge rant on Tumblr. She went off. She was really, really upset. And then soon, We Stand With Taylor started trending. The Swifties got together, honey. They were dragging Scooter Braun. They were dragging Justin Bieber and Kanye West and Kim Kardashian, honey. Because Taylor Swift says that because of Scooter Braun, all of these people basically bullied her. If you guys remember the big drama that went on when Kim Kardashian leaked the private message of Taylor Swift and Kanye West talking. And so she felt like she was being bullied back then. So she was really upset. Justin Bieber came out to speak about the situation, and so did Scooter Braun's wife. You know, Justin apologized for his so-called bullying behavior, but he also feels like Taylor Swift is doing this for attention. She's looking for sympathy. So this entire situation is crazy. I'm gonna go ahead and play you guys this clip. Go ahead and check this out, and I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
There's bad blood in the air between pop superstar Taylor Swift and music executive Scooter Braun, known for managing big name acts including Ariana Grande and Justin Bieber. In a lengthy Tumblr post on Sunday, Swift said she is sad and grossed out over Braun's purchase of Big Machine Label Group, the record company that owns her first 6 albums, which include hits like Shake It Off. The superstar called her deal her worst-case scenario, claiming Braun subjected her to incessant manipulative bullying for years, and by purchasing her music, he would be controlling a woman who didn't want to be associated with him. Swift accuses the music manager of harassing her through his 2 clients, Kanye West and Justin Bieber, on social media, following her feud with West over the rapper's lyrics in his song Famous. The pop star even sharing this 2016 picture of Bieber, West, and Braun, writing, "This is Scooter Braun bullying me on social media when I was at my lowest point." In response to Swift, Bieber shared a lengthy response on Instagram to both support Braun and apologize for his past actions. "Neither Scooter or I have anything negative to say about you. We truly want the best for you." Braun's wife also came to her husband's defense, writing, "My husband is anything but a bully." Swift, who signed to Big Machine at the age of 15, has sold more than 40 million albums for the company. Last November, Swift switched labels and signed with Universal Music Group in an effort to own her music moving forward. She has often spoken up for the rights of songwriters, even taking tech giants like Apple and Spotify to task for what she claimed were unfair business terms. A hashtag, We Stand With Taylor, was trending on Twitter by Sunday evening, with artists like Halsey sharing messages of solidarity. Ending her post with an eye to the future, Swift plugged her upcoming 7th album, saying, "I will always be proud of my past work, but for a healthier option, Lover will be out August 23rd.
And we reached out to Scooter Braun about Taylor Swift's comments and haven't heard back. Big Machine Records founder Scott Brochetta says he never knew of any issues between Swift and Scooter Braun, and he notified Swift's camp of the sale before it went public. Brochetta also claims the pop star turned down the opportunity to stay with the label and gain control over her master recordings.
Wow.
All right.
A lot of bad blood.
It's a fascinating one, and Jenna joins the table as we discuss this. She's not afraid to stand up for herself. That's for sure.
No, but by the way, this is common practice in the record business. This is the model. This is how it works. If you're an artist, you get signed, you get an advance, and you get royalties. You get money in the future, you become wealthy. In exchange for that, you give up the rights to your masters. So this is normal practice. Two noteworthy things here. Taylor just doesn't like the person in Scooter Braun who bought the masters for $300. That's one noteworthy thing. The other thing is Scott Porchetta from Big Machine probably should have called her and said, hey, listen, I've got all of your six albums. I'll give you the right of last refusal. You want to pay $301 million, it'll be yours. But there's a little...
Giving her a heads up.
Right.
I think he did give her a heads up, right?
But he tried to tie that to, you stay with my... She left for Universal.
Yeah.
He said, if you stay with Big Machine... If for every new album you do with me, I'll give you the rights to one of your old So she was tied to that deal.
Yeah.
She said, hey, I want to leave, and I want to take my masters with me. It would have been nice if she had an opportunity to buy it.
Honey. All right, so you guys just saw that video clip. So basically, this is like a slap in the face to Taylor. Taylor definitely has the money to buy her publishing. But like I said, they wanted her to do all types of contractual stuff and make her jump through hoops and hurdles to get her publishing. And so to see Scooter Braun own her publishing is definitely a slap in the face to Taylor. And right now, the music industry is split. You have people like, you know, Demi Lovato having Taylor Swift's back. Other people are saying, you know what? She's looking for attention. That's not fair to blame Scooter. It was up for sale. He bought it. And it's not like he just bought Taylor Swift's music. Let's keep it real. He bought the entire record company. So he also owns other people's records and publishing and everything else, okay? So this entire situation is very sticky. It's really sad that, you know, at 15 years old, her family allowed her to get into this type of contract. But honestly, this is a standard industry contract. And that's why it's very important for people who want to get into the music business. You need to own your masters. You need to own your publishing. You need to know what you're signing, because regardless if you're 15, 18, or 25, once you sign a legal binding contract, they own you. You know, what I find very, very interesting as well is that it was a black man. Yes, a black man named Prince, honey, from Minneapolis, who went on a tirade all those years ago. I was like in the damn fourth or fifth grade back then, where he was, you know, trying to tell people, look, artists, we need to come together. We need to stand, you know, together against these monstrous record labels who are using us. They're making money off of our work, off of our blood, our sweat, our tears, our emotions, everything that we're putting into our music. They're, you know, they're making more off our music than we are, you know. And he even called himself a slave. He changed his name to some symbol. He had slave written on his face, and people dismissed him. They said, oh, he's arrogant. You know, you got fame and fortune. You should just be happy. Why do you need your publishing? Why do you need your masters? He did an interview in Rolling Stone magazine. And in the words of Prince, he said, if you don't own your masters, your master owns you, okay? Y'all thought that black man was playing? Y'all thought he was crazy? Y'all thought he wanted way too much and he should have just been happy? He should have just been a happy little Negro, you know what I'm saying, getting his coins and shutting the fuck up? And Prince refused to shut up. He was speaking for everybody in the industry and for future generations, but people didn't take it seriously.
Well, it's not your game. You didn't make the rules, so everything comes hard. And as long as you're signed to a contract, you're going to take a minority share of the winnings. A select few of us will do well. The majority will not. So as a people, we'll be considered a minority. But stop. Let's take a moment and look at yourselves. There's nothing minor about you. You are a blessed people. You're the most talented on earth, and you are still grateful. That is why upon winning in their game, you always thank God. Tonight, I would like to ask one favor of you. Imagine what we'll all be like in our own game. Peace and love for one another.
But now that we're seeing it happen in real time with Taylor Swift, not everybody's upset. Not everybody's coming to Taylor Swift's defense. That contract that Taylor Swift signed, a six record, you know, contract, was bullshit. You know, it's really sad, but like I said, it's an industry contract. And the fact that it's been 20-something years since Prince was out here fighting for artists to have the rights to their publishing, to their masters, and nothing has changed in 20-something years, that says a lot. You know what I'm saying? That says a lot about where we're at as an industry, as people. And it's really sad that these record labels and these execs, they take advantage of these up-and-coming stars. You know what I'm saying? These kids just want to be famous. They want to get their music out there. That's why they always say, you know, getting into the music industry, it's almost like signing a deal with the devil. You know what I'm saying? Yes, you get the riches. You get the fame. Everybody knows your name. But who really owns you? You know what I'm saying? That's the question you have to ask. And it's not just Taylor. It's a lot of big name people in the industry who do not own their publishings. They don't own their masters, but they're the ones doing the writing. They're doing the work. The only thing they own, if they're lucky enough to own it, is possibly their image. And some celebrities don't even own that. They can't change their hair color. They can't wear what they want to wear. They can't say what they want to say. So, you know, it's very, very tricky. If you want to get into the music industry, you have to know what you're signing. You have to know, most importantly, what you're getting involved with. And what I also find sad is that Scooter Braun, he's now since deleted this Instagram post, but basically one of his friends had tweeted, oh, Scooter Braun now owns Taylor Swift. And we all know about the drama in the past. And he retweeted that, or he reposted on Instagram. And then when he started getting drugged, he deleted it. So Scooter Braun definitely knew what he was doing. But as a business person, I definitely get it. If he has the money to, you know, pay $300 million for a record company and then own Taylor Swift's publishing, why would he not do that? Taylor Swift is one of the most successful women in the music industry, period. You can say you don't like her. You can say she's funny. She's two-faced. You can say whatever you like about her personality. But when it comes to that music, Taylor Swift writes hits. Point blank, period, okay? She's one of the highest grossing female singers out there. And the fact that she doesn't own her own publishing is just really, really sad. And Scooter Braun definitely knew what he was doing. So the industry right now is split. So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. I want to know y'all's thoughts on this entire situation. Do you stand with Taylor Swift? Do you feel like, you know what I'm saying, Taylor Swift should somehow get her masters back? What they're doing is unfair. They're bullying her. And that, you know, Scott Borchetta, he knew what the hell he was doing. Or do you feel like, you know what, at the end of the day, this is business, you know what I'm saying? And her Swifties need to go calm down. You guys can't keep trolling him. This is business. He made a business purchase. It was up for sale. He purchased it. And that's just what it is. And if Taylor really wanted her publishing, maybe she should have followed through what they were asking of her to own her publishing. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire sticky, crazy situation concerning Taylor Swift, Scooter Braun, Scott Borchetta, Justin Bieber, honey, and all of these people getting involved with this discussion. And do you agree with me that artists need to know what they're signing and that it needs to be very, very important that you own your publishing, your masters? You need to think about building generational wealth. And sometimes, you know, for the most part, the average person, even if you sign a contract, you may stay on the shelf. You may never get as big as a Taylor Swift, you know, so you want to own your publishing. You want to own your rights. And I just find it very, very sad that Prince talked about this all those many years ago and people took it as a joke. People dismissed him. And now here we are in 2019 going through the same thing with Taylor Swift. So let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right. Deuces.